After 20 years of teaching teachers to use technology in language teaching, working at the University of Westminster, the University of Warwick, the University of King's College London, and now working with Niall, what are my three biggest pieces of advice and what do they mean in practice? What I'm going to do in this video is highlight three key observations that I've noticed when working with teachers, but then I'm going to make this really practical by showing you lots of specific ideas related to the point I'm going to make. If you watch this video the whole way through, you're going to get loads of ideas that you can try out in the classroom, but you're also going to get a few key principles to think about when you're working with technology and language teaching. Really hope you like the video, and as always, if you do, please like it, please share it with other teachers. I'd love to know which of the ideas that I talk about you find the most interesting. Let's get started. So the first point I want to make is that teachers often know little bits about technologies. What my advice would be to focus on the key technologies and to learn them really well. And this happens to me all the time. When I'm doing training, teachers often say to me, we know this technology. And yet when I demonstrate a few ideas with that technology, they say to me, I didn't realize you can do that. I had exactly this problem this week when I introduced Padlet. And the teacher said to me, yeah, we know this technology. And yet all of them admitted afterwards, and it was a group of about 40 teachers, that none of them actually realized you could do certain things. So I'm going to demonstrate some of those things now. So the first thing is learn a technology really well. And let's look at some examples of what I mean. Let me show you some examples in Padlet, okay? So the sorts of things that where I think that, you know, it's a great tool, it's got loads and loads of options, it's perfect for language teaching, and yet teachers spend time learning other technologies and learning a little bit about them rather than, say, spending a lot of time on Padlet. Let me just do an example with Canvas, because Canvas has got lots of options. I'm just going to demonstrate a couple of things, and I'm going to put here Russell's, and just call this Russell's examples. Okay, so just going to click on next. I'm going to start. First thing I'm going to show you, watch this. I'm going to click on the screen and I'm going to just record myself. So I'm going to say, in fact, I don't even need to put an introduction in. I can do that afterwards. I'm going to click here and I'm going to record myself speaking. So I'm going to do a quick introduction to myself. Okay, so I'm going to click on this button here. Hi, yeah, my name's Russell Stannard. I'm a language teacher. I've worked at various universities, and these days I work for Niall, or I work a lot with Niall, and I'm also the founder of teachertrainingvideos.com. Right, let's finish there. Click on stop. I'm going to save that. Okay, I'm going to put my name here, so I'm going to say Russell says hello. So immediately we've added up an audio file. Okay, I'm going to publish that as well. Okay, so a lot of teachers don't even realize that you can add up audio, but watch this. I'm going to show you another lovely trick. Okay, I'm now going to add up a picture of myself. So I'm going to click on this one here, upload, and I'm just going to quickly go over to my computer. And this is, for example, an idea that I've used many times as a sort of introduction when I want students to meet each other. So I just want to find a really simple picture. That will do fine. I'm going to put that in there. I've uploaded a picture now. I'm going to publish that picture. And what I'm going to do now, this is what you can do if you're in Canvas mode, is that you can click here and you can connect. Okay, and it will show you all the posts on the screen, and you'll say whatever one you want to connect it to. So I want to connect it to that one. And now I've got a connection between the two. So students can easily add up their pictures and then record themselves doing a little introduction and then connect the two objects together. And I presented this last week and a lot of teachers didn't know you could do that. I'm going to show you a second example here. This is what I'm doing currently with the group of students that I've got. So I've asked all the students to record themselves and introduce themselves to the rest of the class. And then what I did is I went over to this button here. I came down and I turned on comments. So you can allow comments. You can come here and turn comments on. Okay, you can turn it off. And turn it on. And by turning on comments, it then meant that students could listen to other people's recordings and then add their comments or questions underneath. So I asked all the students to listen to what other students have written and then to add at least one question underneath two different profiles. Again, such a simple idea because it then gets the students to both record themselves speaking, but then listen to what other people have said and then ask them questions. And then what you can do is you can put the students in groups and get them to discuss the answers to their questions as well. So really, really lovely ideas that work with Padlet. So my advice is, particularly with tools like Padlet, Quizlet, YouTube, these are technologies where we got lots of kind of ways that we can use them in language teaching, and I would really spend my time looking at these technologies with more detail, because it's better to do that than to say no lots of technologies but not really know how they can be used. Now, if you want to know more about Padlet, there's a link now on the screen where you can click on and watch a video that takes you through Padlet in lots of details. I'm now going to move on to my second point. The second key point is that the more you know a technology, the more creative you can be with it. And I'm going to demonstrate one technology now and show you about three or four different ideas that you can do with that, just one technology, to demonstrate how powerful it is when you get really, really sure of a technology. You tend to become much more creative when you know a technology well. I'm going to show you now what is definitely my favorite technology, but I'm going to show you lots of ideas with just one technology. So learning this one technology could allow you to make grammar videos, to give feedback to your students, to get your students to develop their speaking skills, to help your students with, for example, their pronunciation and their vocabulary. Just one technology, so many things that you can do with it. We're going to click on Launch Free Recorder, and it launches this kind of recorder here. And what I'm going to do now is I'm going to minimize my screen, because when you launch the recorder, it opens like a little app. I'm going to minimize that, and in the background here on another page, I've just got some pictures of Tudors. The Tudors were monarchs or in Britain or during the kind of 1400s, 1500s. So I'm just going to just do a little bit of a video about the Tudors. So I'm going to click on this button here to start recording. It's going to record my voice as well, and just imagine this. You know, I could get my students to do this, to talk over a picture or to talk over a series of pictures. But I could be, for example, demonstrating how they do this activity and then send the recording to them. Or I could be talking over a PowerPoint slide now, but I'm just going to demonstrate really simply how it works. So click on here. So this is Anne Boleyn. This is the second wife of Henry VIII. And in fact, it was the reason why he wanted to divorce from Catherine of Aragon. This is a very famous Tudor. It's Elizabeth I. That's actually the daughter of Henry VIII. And finally, this is a picture of Henry VIII, who actually married 6 times. Click on the button. Video, I click on done. That video, click on save. And that video is actually ready. Look, I've made a video in just seconds. And I'm going to play it back now. This is Anne Boleyn. This is the second wife of Henry VIII, and in fact, it was the reason why. And so I could now save that onto my computer, or I could even upload it onto my YouTube channel, or I could even upload it onto my YouTube drive, my Google Drive. Now, I'm going to share a link on the screen so you can learn more about Screencast-O-Matic. It's a fantastic technology. It's free, and you can do so many things with it. But what I'm going to do now is I'm going to just demonstrate some other ideas. Let's look at the whole area of pronunciation and vocabulary and go through an idea. Just a really quick break from the video. I hope you're enjoying the video, and if you are, please come over to teachertrainingvideos.com. Loads more free videos that you can access. You can also find out about all my courses. They're always advertised on the opening page. And please sign up to the newsletter. If you sign up to the newsletter, you get updated with all the blog posts, the webinars, the online courses, and the videos. And at the moment, if you sign up, there is a 12-part free video course in using technology in teaching. And I send you a video about every 5 days. Let's get back to the video. So let's do an example with pronunciation. I'm going to click here on Launch Free Recorder. Again, it opens up the recorder. I'm going to minimize that. And what I've got on the screen this time is some notes from a lesson I've done with my students. And these are some of the words that they were having difficulty with. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to just record myself going through these problematic words, and then I'm going to send them the video. really, really easy. I'm just going to click on the record button to start. So just click on there, it starts to record. And what, remember, whatever you do on the screen, so watch this. If I say, okay, guys, this is the difficult words for this week that I want you to practice the pronunciation. First word, accommodation. Don't forget the stress is on the fourth syllable. Accommodation. Next word, photography. Stress is on the second word. Photograph. Stress is on the first word. So note that we say photography, but we say photograph. This next one is incredulous. Okay, stress is on the second syllable. And the next one, idiomatic. Stress is on the final syllable. Sorry, on the third syllable. Idiomatic. Let's quickly go through those again. Accommodation, photography, photograph, incredulous, idiomatic. See, so I can make that video. Click on done, save that. Now I could email it to my students. I could upload it onto YouTube. So if I click on here, for example, if I've connected my YouTube account, then I can just literally add in a title. So I'm going to call this vocabulary. Okay. And then I can literally publish this on YouTube. Once you've connected your two accounts, and notice I've got a fairly fast internet connection, that video goes straight up onto my YouTube account, and then I can share the link to the video with the students. See, it says copy link. So I could copy that link and now email it to the students. Let's actually have a quick look at that video on YouTube. So I'm going to paste that link in and just press enter. And there is that video already on YouTube. It just takes a few seconds to get ready. And what, remember, whatever you do on the screen, so watch this. If I say, okay, guys, this is the difficult words for this week that I want you to practice the pronunciation. First word, accommodation. Don't forget the stress is on the fourth syllable. Accommodation. Next word. So you can see how easy it is for me to make a video and then share it with my students. Now, I could also get my students to use this technology. Remember, this technology is free. And that's what I'm saying about learning a technology well and becoming creative. Because once you're confident with using this technology, then you can pass it on to your students and get them to do all sorts of things. Speaking, talking over pictures, talking over PowerPoint slides, talking over graphs, talking over maps, answering questions that you've put on the screen, reading out stories, all sorts of things that you could do with this one technology that is completely free. If you want to learn more about screen capture technology in terms of all the different ways it can be used, look at the video that's on the screen now and click on it, and it will show you loads of ideas, both for you as the teacher and the student, different ways that you can use screen recorder software. The third point I want to make is that we really need to focus on looking at tools that can really help our students to study on their own. And we do need to learn about these tools. Now, there are obvious ones, Quizlet, Google Translate, YouTube. And I'm going to highlight some examples in a minute of exactly what I mean. There are many things that you might not know about YouTube that would be great to pass on to your students. And again, when I do the training, teachers often say to me, oh, I didn't realize you could do that. What a great thing to show the students. So I'm just going to highlight examples of what I mean. What I'm trying to say is that we really need to focus on what the students can do on their own and how we can help them to do it more effectively. So let me try and show you some of the fantastic things that you can do with YouTube and that you can show to your students. Whenever I do a questionnaire with teachers, often they say to me YouTube is their most popular technology, but it still amazes me that they don't necessarily know many of the things you can do. Let's look for shopping in English. Okay, so I'm just going to do an example, shopping in English. Okay, so let's imagine that we want to teach our students some English. We're going to get loads and loads of videos. We can see that. But a great thing to show your students, or really useful for you, is that you can filter. So we're going to click here, and what we're going to do is we're going to find videos that are only 4 to 20 minutes long. And also what we're going to do, we're going to filter again, and we're going to find videos with only subtitles. Now we get a whole series of videos. All these videos have got subtitles, really useful. I'm going to click on this first one here. I'm going to show you a couple of things now that you can do straight away. First thing that you can do that's really interesting with the video like this, let me just close that down, is that because you're using subtitles, and it does depend on the type of subtitles, but if they've added the subtitles as a text into YouTube, then you can click here and open the transcript of the video. Okay, now you can even turn off the timings, which can be a really good idea. Okay, now what you can do is jump to any part of the video. So I could jump to here.
Take the Nicorette first.
I can jump to here. Okay, let me just turn off this advert.
Click here to find out more. Fast English.
So the first thing we can do is that we can now use this transcript to click to certain parts and just jump to that part of the video. So in fact, if I was playing this, if I just played a video, and if I jump now to here, and if I jump to here, and it will just jump around in the video to the places that I want to play the video. So that's a really great way of working, the fact that you can just use these transcripts as well. Now I'm going to show you another lovely thing that you can do. Let's imagine that you really like this video and you want to save it. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to click on save, and I'm going to create a new playlist, and I'm going to call this one Shopping Examples in English, so that I can save this in what we call a playlist. Click on create. So let's imagine a few weeks later, we find another video that we really like about shopping, and we want to add it into exactly the same playlist. We can come down to here, click on save, find that Shopping Examples in English, and click on it and add that video. So now we've got two videos saved. So let's imagine then a few weeks later that we suddenly find another video that we like, and we think, okay, we want to share this and keep it with all our other videos about shopping. So this is great for teachers because they can build collections of videos that they can share with the students, or great for students if they want to study on their own. So you come down to save again, it gives you the list of all your a list of all the playlists that you've created. Click on the one that's the correct one, and then add that. So now I've got three videos in my playlist. Now you might ask yourself, well, where'd you find your playlist? Well, easy, just click over here and come down here and you'll see all your playlists. Now I've got hundreds. I use playlists all the time for many of the things that I'm interested in, like learning music, so playing the guitar, things about technology, things about studying for about, languages. For example, I have playlists for Polish, for example, Polish television series that I like, all sorts of things. But if we come here, we can see that playlist that you and I just created together. I can come up here and I can see it here, Shopping Examples. I can click on it and it shows me the three videos. So I've got them always together. Now there's lots of great things about this playlist as well. Let's have a quick look at some of the things we can do with it. Now there are lots of things you can do with playlists, and if you want to learn more, I'm going to put a link on the screen now to a video that goes into playlists in detail, but I'm just going to focus on a few things. First of all, you can always delete an object from a playlist. So if you come over here and decide, well, you don't want that video in that playlist, you can just delete it from there. Another thing about your playlists is that you can make them public if you want other people to find them, and people often do that. Collections of videos around speaking in English or shopping in English or whatever, then people often make them public so that other people can find those playlists. People do that a lot, for example, with music. Then you can actually make a playlist public, though if you're going to work with your students and you don't want to make it public, we'll make it unlisted. That's the best thing to do, because then only people with the link can access the playlist. Now, if you wanted to share this playlist with your students, the easiest thing to do is to click on play all. And it will open up the playlist and start to play it, and now we can see that. And we've got the option now to actually share this playlist with our students. The easiest way is just to click on share and to copy that link. If you copied that link and then sent that to your students would also be able to access your playlist. Now there's lots more things that you can do with YouTube. I've just showed you a couple of things. If you want to learn more about some of the things you can do with YouTube, there's a video on the screen now that you can click on that will go through many more features in YouTube. Really hoped you liked that video. Please come over to teachertrainingvideos.com. Loads more free content, and you can see all of my courses on the opening page. Don't forget to sign up to the newsletter. That way you get updated with all the latest blog posts, the webinars, the latest videos and the courses. Of course, you can subscribe to my YouTube channel. Don't forget to click on the bell. That way you'll get all the updates. And finally, if you do want to contact me, perhaps about doing a conference or doing some training with your organization, you can contact me from the website. Thank you very much. On the screen now, I'm going to leave you some more videos that you might find really useful to do with language teaching and technology.